In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of ventricle. This is ventricle. It's located on a deep place of brain. In first part, I'm going to explain anatomy of ventricles. Then on second part, I'm going to explain where it is. Okay, so this is lateral view. You are looking ventricle from the side. Okay, so the first two places I want to explain is these two guys, basically these places. Okay, so this whole place is lateral ventricle because it's on the lateral part. There are two lateral ventricles, and this is anterior horn of lateral ventricle. This is posterior horn. This is inferior horn. Anterior, posterior, and inferior. Speaking about posterior horn, only 12% of population have fully developed posterior horn. Other people's posterior horn is not completely developed, or some people lacks posterior horn. Okay? Anterior horn, posterior horn, and inferior horn. And this place is trigone of lateral ventricle. Okay? Lateral ventricle. Okay, so let's go to this place. This is on the midline part. Okay, this place. This part is third ventricle. Because there are two lateral ventricles. 1, 2, and 3. Third ventricle. You see this hole? There is interthalamic adhesion. Interthalamic adhesion is like a bridge between thalamus, okay? Third ventricle and interthalamic adhesion. And this part, you see, this part is interventricular foramen. Interventricular foramen. Lateral ventricle and third ventricle. Now there is fourth ventricle, but before I'm going to fourth ventricle, I want to go to one place here. This connects third ventricle and fourth ventricle. This is cerebral aqueduct. Cerebral aqueduct. There is midbrain here, and cerebral aqueduct kind of penetrates in the midbrain. Third ventricle, cerebral aqueduct, then fourth ventricle, because there's 1, 2, 3, and 4, fourth ventricle. Okay, review of first part. This is lateral ventricle, anterior horn, posterior horn, inferior horn, trigone, third ventricle, interthalamic adhesion, interventricular foramen, cerebral aqueduct, and fourth ventricle. Now on next part, I'm going to put other brain models so you can see the relationship with other places. Okay, this is a combination of other places. The left hemisphere is removed. This is right hemisphere of cerebrum. See, this part is lateral ventricle. You remember this is posterior horn. Let's remove right hemisphere. Then let's remove this one. This is a corpus callosum. Corpus callosum connects right hemisphere and left hemisphere. Corpus callosum is on the ventricle. Now let's remove the temporal lobe like that. Now what you're looking is, this is insula. This is insula, and this part is midbrain, pons, and medulla. So this is brain stem. So lateral ventricle is very close to insula and other tissue, like a basal ganglia. Okay, now let's remove even other tissues. I'm going to remove left brain stem. So what you are looking is This part is midbrain, and this is pons. This is medulla. Do you remember this structure? This is cerebral aqueduct that penetrates midbrain. And this is false ventricle. Anterior from false ventricle, this is pons. And posterior from false ventricle, what is it? This is cerebellum. Okay, so false ventricle has relationship with cerebellum and pons. Okay. By the way, this is interthalamic adhesion. And this part from third ventricle is hypothalamus. Thalamus and hypothalamus. You see the relationship with ventricles and brain stem. That's why this is very, very deep structure, but it's very important structure as well. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of ventricle. And on the second part, I explained relationship with other places. This place is so, so important for clinically and understanding neuroanatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.